The quick setup of the Joule Master Immersion System is one of its most valuable features. The solution is stored in the resealable working beakers. There are few other parts and no connection wires. After the beaker lids are removed, the solution electrodes are set into each of the solution beakers and the gold-plated bus bars are positioned over the plating cells to hold and charge the parts being plated. The first two rinse water beakers are filled with clean tap water. The third beaker is filled with distilled water. For warm-up, the heater control is set to high, the power switch is set to on, and the output voltage is adjusted to 6 volts. Before the plating begins, the parts are polished if necessary and washed with warm soapy water to remove any polishing or foreign debris. The parts are then set in the rack. The racks that hold the parts are normally made of copper, specifically shaped for the parts being plated. After warm-up, before starting to plate, the temperature of the plating solution is checked. For our 24-karat bright gold solution, the correct temperature is between 95 and 105 degrees Fahrenheit. 100 degrees is optimum. The heater control should now be set to the low position. The first plating step is to hang the racked parts on the bus bar into the electro cleaner solution. These parts are electro cleaned for about 20 seconds. The purpose of this step is to clean the surface and remove material that could affect the plating. Notice the light gassing at the surface of the coins. This means the process is working. After electro-cleaning, the parts are rinsed in the first clean water rinse beaker. The rack is then placed in the surface activator solution for about 20 seconds. This step activates the surface and prepares it for the gold plate. Notice again the light gassing. After activation, the parts are rinsed in the second clean water rinse. While the rack is in the second rinse beaker, the output voltage is set to 3 volts. Our 24-karat bright gold solution is extremely concentrated and plates very fast at low voltage. Before going into the gold solution, the rack is dipped in the distilled water rinse to ensure that the gold solution is not contaminated. After the distilled water rinse, the rack is set into the gold plating solution, hanging it onto the bus. The voltage is again checked. When the rack is set on the bus, the voltage may drop a little. It should now be adjusted to 2.5 to 2.7 volts. If the voltage is too high, it can cause the gold plate to dull and darken. We are plating these coins for a total of 3 minutes. This will produce a good decorative gold thickness of around 15 microinches. The plating time can be measured with a timer or by watching the second hand on a wall clock. After half of the plating time has elapsed, the rack is rotated so both sides of the parts get equal exposure to the anode. When the total plating time has elapsed, the parts are rinsed in the distilled water to remove excess plating solution. If several racks are going to be plated before changing the distilled water, a second distilled water rinse may be added to ensure all plating solution is removed from the parts. Now the rack is unloaded and the parts are dried. Freshly plated gold is easily stained by water spots or the oil on fingers. To help prevent this, wax or gold shield can be applied. When finished with the plating project, it's quick and easy to put the Jewel Master away. First, the heater and power switches are set to the off position. Then, the solution electrodes are removed, rinsed, and dried. The gold-plated bus bars are removed and wiped with a damp paper towel. Finally, the lids are replaced onto the solution beakers. With the Jewel Master, it is fast, easy, and fun to produce professional results for gold plating smaller parts. When making your final decision as to a gold plating purchase, give yourself the advantage of the finest equipment, supplies, technical support, and service available anywhere. Choose professionalism and choose the best by choosing gold plating services.